The Western Energy Alliance says onshore oil and gas production in the U.S. is projected to exceed oil and gas imports from Saudi Arabia, Iraq, Kuwait, Venezuela, Algeria, Nigeria, and Russia by 2020.
The West alone has the potential to produce more than 1.3 million barrels of oil every single day.
Western Energy Alliance has created an interactive exhibit in the lobby of the 1700 Broadway building in downtown Denver.
An oil drilling boom is creating jobs across the West, and energy companies have only just started to tap the potential.
So we have a huge energy potential. But what's threatening that, us realizing that full potential, is overregulation.
Consider the listing of endangered species.
The listing decision relied on an unpublished report, non-peer-reviewed science.
No one of us wants to see a species be extinct or go extinct, but what we've seen is an extreme interpretation of the rules which kill jobs.
They have no regard for jobs and economic activity in rural communities across the West or across the nation for that matter.
Western Energy Alliance is a great asset to our industry, and they keep up on all the rules and regulations and help us fight the fight.
Our members are proud to provide 27% of the nation's natural gas and 14% of the nation's oil production while disturbing only 0.07% of public lands.
Secretary of Interior, do you intend to protect the private property rights of companies that are holding federal oil and gas leases that have been signed and issued?
The answer is we will protect private property rights and follow the law in terms of what the law requires us to do.
We will now go to the next witness, Mr. Randy Bowles, Manager, Regulatory Affairs, Devon Energy.
As you can see, Mr. Chairman, categorical exclusions provide BLM with the ability to offer a practical environmental review while avoiding a lengthy and often duplicative NEPA effort.
The balance has tipped too far toward constraining oil and gas development at the expense of government revenue, jobs, and the economy.
If government policies don't get in the way, we are able to create about 70,000 jobs.
My next question is obvious. We can do that without any government stimulus. Is that correct?
That is correct.